Let us see the third chapter in the subject PLC and SCADA. The chapter is Special Programming Instructions, and this chapter carries 30 marks in the final examination, and those 30 marks are distributed as two questions of 5 marks and two questions for 10 marks. So already the question bank is given to you in the notes, and the question bank is given to you in the printout. I have already accumulated all the questions in one page and given to you, and already you have solved those questions. The same questions I am repeating here. Okay, the first question is describe multiply, add and subtract instructions. Okay, so these questions will be asked for 5 marks maybe. The multiply instruction, the MUL, that is MUL, multiply instruction, is used to multiply one value stored in source A by another value stored in source B, and the result of the multiplication is placed in destination. So during multiplication, both source and A can be either constant values or addresses of the addresses where the values are present. That is, directly we can multiply or indirectly. So if you are specifying the addresses where the values are stored, it is indirect. Okay, then going to sub instruction, subtraction instruction. So the subtraction instruction is used to subtract two values and the result, to store the result in the destination. That is, when the wrong condition becomes true, okay, the subtraction instruction starts executing. When the wrong condition becomes true, the sub output instruction subtracts source B from source A, that is the two numbers which are stored in source A and source B, and the result is stored in the destination. The destination will be mentioned in the program. The source and source A and source B either can be values or addresses. Both source A and source B cannot be constants here. That is the restriction while subtracting. Then next, coming to the add instruction. So this add instruction is used to add the two values which are stored in two places, maybe source A and source B, and the result is stored in the said destination. That destination direction is given in the program. Okay, so this add instruction, when the wrong condition is true, the add output instruction adds source A and source B, and the result is stored in the directed destination. The destination is directed to the system in the program itself. The once again, the source and source A and source B, both values can be two values, or those may be the addresses of the values which the values present in the memory location. The address of the memory location is mentioned in the program. Now coming to next instructions are negate instruction and clear instruction. Negate means become reversing, that is negating the number, changing the sign of the number. If the number is positive, it will be negated. If the number is already negative, it becomes positive. And clear instruction means the said location will be cleared to zero. The negate instruction, when the wrong conditions are true, the negate instruction changes the sign of the source and places it in the destination. The source and destination both will be directed to the system in the program itself. Then the clear instruction, as I told, the clear instruction used to clear the memory location. That is, the memory location which may have some value, that value is cleared, means made to zero. When the wrong condition goes true, the output sets all the bits in the word, that is in the mentioned word to zero. Okay, whatever may be the value present after execution of the clear instruction, it becomes zero. Upon execution of this instruction, all arithmetic status bits are reset. Then next question, explain on delay time instructions, on delay timer, explain on delay timer instruction. An on delay timer instruction is used to program a time delay before an instruction becomes true. Its operation is as below. When the rung becomes true, the timeout period commences. At the end of timeout period, an output is made true. The output becomes true after some time of the rung becomes true. That is, when the rung becomes true, for example, now what we are doing is, when the input, for example, if the input becomes true, then after some time, the output is to be activated. After some time, the output is to be activated. Suppose we have to we have to include a time delay between the activation of the input and activation of the output. So this on delay timer instruction is used. Next, coming to the off delay timer. Here in off delay timer, it is used to include a delay after the output is energized or the output after the output is activated. And an off delay timer is used to program a time delay after an instruction becomes true. Its operation is as below. When the rung is true, the timeout period commences. At the end of timeout period, an output is made true. The output becomes true after some time of the rung becomes true. Next is, describe up counter instruction. The up counter is an output instruction whose function is to increment its accumulated value on false to true transaction of its instruction. It can be used to count false to true transaction of an input instruction and then to trigger an event after a required number of counts. Here, for example, suppose we are counting. So you can take one example, the number of persons entering into the hall for the security purpose, there will be some door will be kept, and when we cross the door, the person will be counted as one. You might have seen this type of arrangement in some public places, whereas in some temples or where the public is to be controlled or where the public is to be monitored. So here, from the door, whenever the person enters, okay, a sensor and a light source and a light detector will be fixed on both sides of the door, and whenever the person passes through, the light ray will be cut and it will be counted. So in those cases, when the light ray is cut, when the person enters into the room through that door, the input transacts from low to high. The input transacts from low to high. Every time the input transacts from low to high, it is counted. And after a particular number of count, we can stop the counter and we can proceed further. Okay, or we can trigger any event. That is, after some 10 or 100 people have entered into the room, automatically the door has to close. Or when the parking lot becomes busy, if all the parking lots in the parking area is full, then main door will be closed. Okay, so in such type of cases, this up counter type of instructions are used. Similarly, so the up counter instruction, this ladder diagram for the up counter instruction can be seen in the diagram. Then the down counter instruction, it is same as that of up counter instruction, but here it acts in reverse order. That is, whenever the input transaction traverses from 0 to high or from low to high, the counter decrements to 1 and it counts till it becomes 0. or the counter is reduced by 1 and it goes on counting till it becomes 0. When the counter becomes 0, we can activate the, or we can trigger the output activity. That is, suppose we have to close the door. The ladder diagram for a down counter is shown in this figure. Then next is, explain the copy instruction, COP, copy file instruction. When rung conditions are true, this output instruction, a user defined source parse is a source file is copied to a destination file. The copy instruction does not use status bits. If you need an enable bit, program a parallel output that uses a storage address. Simply, this instruction is used to copy one file from one place to other place. Okay. So next, coming to the division instruction, divide. When the rung conditions are true, this output instruction divides source A by source B and stores the result in the destination and the math register. The destination and where the data is to, where the result is to be stored, where the two source A, where the source B is stored in the memory, etc., are mentioned in the program. Then next is the move instruction. The move instruction is an output instruction that moves copy of one data word to a specified destination. When instruction is true, information specified as source A is moved to the location, specific location source B. Here we can say it acts in the similar way as that of copy, but the copy instruction is used to copy the file, whereas this move instruction is used to move a 16-bit data from one word location to the another word location. Then next, what are the factors depend on which we are going to select a PLC? So there are many factors while selecting a PLC for a purpose. The different factors come into picture. So we have to take care of those factors so that the selected PLC will fulfill our requirement. So the following factors are the factors which are to be considered while selection of a PLC. So first is cost of hardware or software. So cost of hardware and software should be minimum as much as possible. Okay, so that is quite common. So everybody will expect that the cost of hardware and software must be minimum, cheaper. Then design, installation, startup, commissioning. So this factor comes. Okay, so design, installation, startup and commissioning need expert persons. Okay, so we have to select a PLC such that the design, installation, startup and commissioning will be as easy as possible. Okay, as easy as possible. Then documentation and execution. So documentation means storing the results in the memory. Then execution means execution of the program. So program execution must be as faster as possible. That is the expectation. The reliability, the how long the that is life of the system. Then flexibility. Flexibility means we should have sufficient amount of flexibility to make any changes in the system so that we can use the same system for, or we can reprogram the same system, same PLC for other tasks also. Then scalability. Then training and spare parts. So spare parts, once again, availability of the spare parts is much important. So when we select a PLC and we install in our factory or something, then if it goes wrong anywhere, then, or if any spare part, any part gets failed because of some unwanted conditions or unavoidable conditions, then availability of the spare parts must be very easy, and training for the operation, a training for the operator must be available from the company which is supplying the PLC. ease of database configuration. So the database configuration must be very easy so that we can use it. Okay, the any person can use it in our destination. Then integration of high level applications. So the PLCs which we have selected in limited range, it must be able to upgrade for high levels also. Okay, in some limitations. So these are some questions which I have listed by referring some previous question papers. So please go through the video and please refer the notes also. The same thing is given in the notes also. And already you have solved these questions in the classroom. Okay, so keep in touch. Okay, go through the slides. Okay, keep reading. Okay, and be prepared for the examinations. Thank you, thank you one and all.